The United States Navy is bringing in much-needed equipment and personnel to help contain the Oriental Mindoro oil spill. The U.S. is sending Hydro's remotely operated vehicle featuring full manipulator arms for oil containment and recovery. The ROV is expected to begin work on April 1st. Other assets include a harbor boom, a van for maintenance and repairs, and a decontamination van for oiled equipment or boom. The U.S. Navy will also be deploying several boats and all-terrain vehicles. The Philippine Coast Guard thanked the U.S. government for extending resources and technical experts to assist in the crisis.
In other news, some 81 Filipinos still facing a death sentence overseas. The Foreign Affairs Department says it continues to exhaust all diplomatic means to spare the Filipinos from execution. The agency also reports 135 Filipinos have been acquitted in three regions through Manila's Illegal Assistance Fund. Most of them were Filipinos in the Middle East, and three others were in Asia and Africa. 69 Filipinos, meanwhile, received pardons for drug trafficking, prostitution, and theft. The proposed merger of Land Bank and the Development Bank of the Philippines, opposed by another lawmaker. Senator Rizon-Tivero says the Marcos administration should tread cautiously on this proposal. She warns merging the two to create the country's largest bank in terms of assets would make it an entity that's too big to fail. Ontivero says she will file a resolution urging the Senate to exercise its oversight function on the proposed merger. The chairman of the Senate Ways and Means Committee, Sherwin Gatchalian, had earlier warned the proposal could create a super monopoly.
Dahil may monopoly siya ng LGU deposits at dati nakakapili pa yung mga LGUs between Land Bank or DDP, ngayon isa na lang at wala silang choice. So kung masama ang servisyo ng super monopoly, wala silang choice. Kung mataas ang interest rates sa kanilang loans, wala silang choice. So it's bad for our local government.
Philippine medical experts urge the public to prepare for tropical diseases brought by the El Nino phenomenon. Department of Health Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Vergere cited a variety of possible epidemics, such as cholera, dengue, malaria, and typhoid fever. She cautioned that most of these illnesses arise from the water crisis brought by the hot weather.
Most important would be na lahat tayo dapat aware tayo, lahat tayo alam natin ang gagawin natin kapag ka nangyari yan para maiwasan ang sakit. Katulad ng dapat siguraduhin lagi na ligtas ang tubig na ating iniinom. So it all boils down to good hygiene, good food preparation, and of course this source of water ay kailangan po laging malinis para maiwasan ang sakit.
The Philippine Federation of Professional Associations has outlined some measures to avoid heat exhaustion. It noted the most important is to stay hydrated by drinking at least 2 liters of water a day.
Huwag masyadong iinom at kakain ng matatamis kasi yun eh nakakaano yung sugar mag ano niya yung tubig para ilabas. Oh. Kaya yung soft drinks din natin binibigay sa mga yung uhaw na uhaw kasi lalo kang uuhawin. Oh. Lalo yung alcohol, dapat bawasan ang alcohol during summer.